Good morning. We are glad to see you at today's children's service. Today we'll be looking at what the children get up to in church, and us youth will be playing for two worship songs. At the start of our time together, let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you for this opportunity to pray and worship you. We pray for fellow Christians who cannot do this freely. We thank you for Orlando and everyone who helps us with the youth band and clique. And we pray for the helpers at Epic and Lighthouse. We thank you for all they do and help them as they continue to share your message and plan the upcoming holiday club. We pray for Stuart as he tells us your word. Please speak through him and be close to us today and for the rest of the week, we pray. Amen.
Please take your seats, everybody. Wonderful to see you and to see families and friends in today for our celebration of the young life in our church. We have a number of things that happen quite often away from the focus of Sunday. So, for example, and I can see some of you here this morning that come along to Friday Fun Time on Friday mornings. And that's a mother and toddler group, and they come down and they have fun, they ride, and there is something else that we do on Friday morning. And it happens to have slipped my mind right at the moment. What else do we do on Friday morning? We eat, don't we? It is a colloquially friendly name as the Cake Club on Friday. So that happens on Friday evening. We have Epic, and Epic is our youth club for primary school age children, and there will be 30 to 40 children from the ages of about 4 through to 11 that come down and have fun on Friday. Now, most of us don't see that, but we're so thankful to God for the staff that supervise it and lead it, and for all the children. And I can see a number of you here today that come to Epic on Friday. So fantastic. We're so glad you're here. And then on Sunday, we have Lighthouse, which happens before our service. And those of us who are around church from 11 o'clock, we often see the children. But others of you might not know that Lighthouse happens. And that's where the time is really spent digging in and helping the children understand the Bible. And we're celebrating today the children in our church and the ministries that they have. And isn't it wonderful to have our youth band playing this morning? So as we go through from children to teens, they start to grow up. And one of the big things that's happened over the last year is we've had our youth band have been playing, and they're putting together a repertoire. So we're so grateful for them. And Ivy, for starting us off so well, thank you. So that's what we're doing today. And we just want to highlight the different things that happen. All the songs being chosen by the children in Lighthouse. So that first song is one of their favorite ones. Children, I hope you enjoyed that. Got a couple more coming up a little bit later with some actions and all of that. Might want to join in with those. But first of all, we're going to have a video that flags up, highlights what happens in Epic. I haven't seen this. I have no idea what's coming. But this is Epic on Friday night.
Jesus. precious son down and set me free. Everything of this world will fade. I'm pressing on till I see your face. I will live that your will be done.
It looks epic. Give a big round of applause for Epic. Excellent. And one of the things on there was, what have we learned to Epic? And one of the things was, Jesus loves us and Jesus is always with us. This morning, we're going to be thinking about that idea and how Jesus is a friend. So we're going to think about Jesus being our best friend. And I thought, where do we start with that? And I got a lovely video. If you like Winnie the Pooh, we got a Winnie the Pooh video to start us off this morning. Thanks, Martin.
Deep in the 100-acre wood, Christopher Robin and his friends have had many wonderful adventures. Come now, and I'll show you one. One day, Pooh and the others decided to show Piglet what an exceptionally good friend he was. So they presented him with a very special surprise.
Piglet, we realize you are a hero.
Oh, I've never done anything great.
Well, of course you have. Let's tell him, everyone.
No, let's show him.
That's wonderful. Come on. Here we are.
Go on.
Look inside.
Is that me?
That's you.
I'm so big.
Why, you're double XL.
If it weren't for you, Piglet, I wouldn't be friends with Roo.
Yeah, and thanks for saving me with the North Pole.
Oh.
Piglet. Pooh Corner's not a bad place to live.
I'd say this calls for a celebration.
Come on, chase me. Come on, you can do better than that.
Here I go.
Get him!
Oh. Oops, sorry.
That's funny.
Oh, my.
Piglet.
Do something, everyone.
Oh, dear.
Good one, Piglet.
That's funny.
His carrot cake.
Rabbit, you're a nut.
It's delicious.
Where's Pooh?
This is a hero party, Piglet. Because you are a hero.
Thank you, Pooh.
On that day, Piglet learned that even though he was quite small, to his friends he had made a very big impression, and that was certainly worth celebrating.
Mm-hmm. And what we find at Epic and Lighthouse and a bit of Friday Fun Time is that Jesus is a better friend than even than Pooh. And it reminds me of a verse in the Bible, and I need your help with this, children. I probably grown-ups as well at this point. All I could remember was the start of it, which says there is a friend who, and I was thinking of Winnie the Pooh, and I got stuck on who. So there is a friend who helps with the clicker when the clicker doesn't work. Right, there is a friend who, so we've got to try and think who that might be. There is a friend who, grown-ups, if anybody's got any ideas, you can help me with it. Could it be a friend who loves picking up sticks? No, it's not. It's not pick sticks. Sticks, though, that does ring a bell. Sticks. There is a friend who sticks. Maybe who throws sticks at the grocer. Would that be a friend, do you think? A friend who throws sticks? No. Any ideas? Grocer. Sticks. Ah, who sticks better than butter? That is it, isn't it? There is a grown-ups, is that what it is in the Bible? There is a friend who sticks better than butter. Rosemary doesn't think it is. Who agrees with Rosemary? Right, it's not that. All right. There is a friend who sticks. Anybody any ideas? Ted? Closer. Let's have a look. Sticks like butter to his sticks like butter to his brother. Brother, what were you going to say? Because I clicked that on too quick, Ted. What were you going to say? Sticks closer than a brother. Sticks better than a brother? No, I think you're probably right. Sticks closer than a brother. That is it. That was the verse. And it's in Proverbs 18, verse 24. And that's what the Bible says. And it's talking about God. It's talking about Jesus. There is a friend who sticks closer than a brother. See, the point is, how many of you have got brothers and sisters? How many of you got, yeah. How many of you have got brothers? Right? You got sisters. All right. So the point, what the Bible's saying here, is that there's someone who sticks better even and sticks closer and is always better than even the people who you'd think are going to be with you the whole time. That Jesus is the best friend ever. Question. What do you think is the problem with this little boy here? And who does he need? What does he need? He needs a friend, doesn't he? What does he need the friend to do? Maybe play with him. What is this? What is he doing? What's he doing? Where is he? He is colouring. Well, it's sort of colouring. It's a special kind of colouring. I remember being like this at school. It looks to me like Samuel. He needs a teacher. What were you going to say, Luke? Someone to help him. I think he's stuck at school. He needs a teacher. Yeah, and he needs a friend. Oh, what do we need? If we were to go outside and we've seen on the news at the moment, there's some big fires. We need a grown-up. We absolutely do. What kind of grown-up do we need for that situation? A fireman. Yes, we need. Is that what you said? A firefighter. Yes, we need somebody to come and put the flames out. We do. What about this one? What's happening in this picture here, do you think? What do you think is happening here? God. Yeah. All the friends are in the background, they're playing, and that little girl is sitting there by herself, and she hasn't got anybody to play with. She needs a friend, doesn't she? All right, this one. An old car, yeah. What's happened to the old car? It's broken down, so who does this lady need? Who could she be phoning up? Yes, a mechanic. You're right. Somebody to come and help. Maybe the RAC or Green Flag or the AA. Somebody like, she needs a friend. That's right. We all need friends. And, what about that one, the last one? He did hurt his knee. What do you need if you hurt your knee? A plaster. Do you know what? I got some plasters today. So if you fall over and you hurt yourself, I have got just what you need. And actually, I'm going to use the plasters to help us understand what a good friend Jesus is. You see, if you fall over and you cut your knee like that, then you've got to put a plaster on it. And my box of plasters here says that these plasters are good for all kinds of things. They help us in all things. One of the things it says on here, so we need to think about Jesus, the best friend, the friend who sticks closer than a brother, a friend who sticks better than a plaster, I'm going to say as well, this morning. And here's the reason why he's a good friend. Who can read what it says on there? Jesus, the best friend ever. Who can read the next line? Anybody going to help me on that one? Go on, Caleb. Yeah, you can have a go. It's okay, not a problem. Who wants to have a go? Ted? Yeah, Jesus, the best friend ever, because he sticks with you wherever you go. And on my box of plasters on there that you can see, because you won't see it on here, but you'll see it on there, where the arrow goes, can you see what it's pointing to? Some words on there. It says extra plasters. There are extra plasters in the box, but that's not what it says there. Extra. What did Mum say? She did. She got it right. Extra flexible. Extra flexible. So it's bendy, and it means when you put it on your knee, it doesn't come off. And if you put it on your arm, it won't come off. It will bend when you bend. Nothing worse than putting a plaster on, is the parents, than putting a plaster on, only to find that they've fallen off a few minutes later, and they're doing no good whatsoever. You need to have a plaster that bends with you, that's flexible, so you can go wherever you want. Some plasters, it says that they're waterproof, so you can even go swimming, and they don't fall off. The Bible says that Jesus is a friend who is with us the whole time. Where is Ted? Ted, could you come and read that bit of the Bible that you've got for us? Do you want to come onto one of these microphones? I'll do it from this one here, and I'll tip that one down for you. Yeah, you can read that little bit for us. Listen, that this is what the Bible says. You read that for us, Ted.
Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I make my bed in the depths, you are there. If I rise on the wings of the dawn, if I settle on the far side of the sea, even there your hand will guide me. Your right hand will hold me fast. If I say, surely the darkness will hide me, and the light will come, and the light will become night around me, even the darkness will not be dark to you. The night will shine like the day, for darkness is as light to you. Psalm 139 from verse 7.
Fantastic. Good lad. That is brilliant. Well, really well read. Yes. And so just to help us remember what that said in there, it said that Jesus sticks with us all the different places that we can go. Here's some pictures. Right. Submarines have been in the news. Where do submarines go? They do. They go in the water, and they go right under the water. And the Bible said that even if we go right under the water, like in a submarine, Jesus is there. We can't get away from him. He's there as well. Who knows what that is? It's a kind of aeroplane. Caleb? It is a kind of spaceship. It's a very special kind of spaceship. It's a spaceship that you can see if you look outside at night sometimes. It's not really a satellite, but it's kind of a satellite. Come on, grown-ups, who's going to do it? It's the space station, right? And you can see at night, you can see it go. It's the brightest thing that goes across our sky sometimes at night when you can see it. So it's the space station, and people actually go and live on there for several months at a time. So even if you go right up into the sky, into space, it says that Jesus is there as well. And it said, can you see what that is? It's the sea. And I'm thinking sometimes when you look out to sea, and it's a long way, isn't it? And the Bible says, even if you go as far as you can over the sea, so if you got in a boat and rowed and went right over the straight bit, what's that straight bit called that goes across in the middle? It's called the horizon. Yes, if you go over the horizon, that still goes on, but Jesus will be there as well. So as far away as we go, we can't get away from him. And last one, what is that? What time of day is that? It's night time. It is. Even in the night time, time, Jesus is with us. He can see us and he knows everything. So whatever we do, wherever we go, whatever time of day or night, that is why Jesus is like the best friend. Because friends and brothers and mums and dads can't be with us all the time, but Jesus is always with us. Right, we're going to pause there. And I think we're going to have a couple of the Lighthouse are going to sing a couple of songs with us. We're all going to join in, but they're going to come and do some actions, I hope. So come on, Lighthouse, we're going to sing, you're going to sing, we're going to sing together. Peace like a river, and God always keeps his promises. I've heard you singing this on Sunday morning in Lighthouse. If any of the teachers and leaders want to come and join in and help them and encourage them, that'd be fantastic. But here we go. If you're not around on Sundays, you might not know these two songs, but don't worry. Just stand up if you want to. If you prefer and or can't stand up, it's okay if you stay in your seats. But other than that, let's stand up and encourage the children as we sing this song together. All right. Are you all right, guys? You're going to sing well? Lots of action. Show us how the actions goes. Here we go, Martin. We'll do a second song as well. And we got the works up here this morning. Ain't it great to see these little ones? We love it.
Oh God, he always keeps said his son would set us free. Through his death at Calvary, he suffered in our place. And then he rose up from the grave. Our God is good and true. He cannot lie to me and you. We can be sure of this. God always keeps his promises. Our God is good and true. He cannot lie to me and you. We can be sure of this. God always keeps his promises. God always keeps his promises.
Please take your seats. Two more things from our plasters that we can learn about Jesus. There is so much stuff up here that's fascinating, isn't there? We don't mind as long as they don't touch stuff. They are welcome to be where they want. Right, so two more things. Let's go back to the PowerPoint and we'll see on here what it says on the packet of the plasters. Where's the PowerPoint, Martin? Here we go. He's working overtime. Right, so that was the reading that Ted said about that we can't go away from Jesus wherever it is. Then flexible, we've seen that sticks with us wherever we go. There's more to being a plaster than that. There's more for Jesus being a friend than that as well. A plaster, what does this one say? A plaster and Jesus, what does it say? Who can read the next line down? Who wants to read it for me? Ted, come on. Yeah, that's what the plasters say they do. They help and heal. And if you see the arrow, it's pointing to the bit there. It says prevents infection up to 2 times faster healing. So, mums, adults, when you put a plaster on, you're not just covering it up. You're actually helping the, at least if you use these ones, and there are other brands available. But it helps speed up the process of making the cut better. You know, the Bible says that we've got something worse than a cut wrong with us. It talks about the fact that we've done things that make God sad and that mean that when we die, we won't be able to be with him. And that's really sad. So we need to be made better from that. Those of you in the lighthouse, what's the word that it uses, the Bible uses, when we've done things that are not right, when we've made God sad? Samuel, it's sin. Do we all agree it's called sin in the Bible? Yep. I'm seeing lots of nods around. So we need to get better. And Jesus, that's what he came for, to help us get better and to make us better from our sin. And that last song talked about Jesus. Talked about, do you remember? You saw the words dying on the cross and coming back to life. And he did that so that our sins, whether we're little or whether we're really, really old, like me and your granddads, stop laughing, that the things that we do can be forgiven. And that Jesus can be our friend and be with us the whole time. So he heals us and he makes us better. Better than a plaster can. Because it can make us better physically, make a cut better, but it can't get us into heaven. So that's, and then the last one, the last thing about our plasters is, oh, I was going to say a bit about them. Do you know what that is? Well, that's a picture of. Samuel's on form today. Do you know what it is? Yeah, it's a germs. And we know lots about germs now, don't we, from having the coronavirus and COVID and washing our hands because we know that germs make us ill. And so we have to get clean from our germs. And I was just going to say that Jesus doesn't just deal with germs. That's what we have our hand gel for. But sin is like a germ and it gets in and it makes us so we do things wrong and it spoils. They are the germs. They're so small that you can't see them in real life. That's under a microscope to make them bigger. Yeah. So this is the last one I was going to say. What can... the arrow is pointing to a word. Can you read it? A long, long word. Who can read that long word? Dr. Daniel, can you read? Yes, hypoallergenic. Who knows what hypoallergenic means? Probably lots of you. Who's willing to have a go and tell me what it means? Or do I go back to the doctor? No, I'll tell you what it means. It means that it's been tested on skin, and it means that it will be safe on most people's skins. Okay? Because some people have got skin that when you put a plaster on, the sticky stuff reacts with the skin, and it might bring them out, make them go all red, or it might be itchy, and that kind of stuff. Well, these plasters have been tested so that the sticky stuff and the material in the plaster doesn't make people poorly. And the word for that is hypoallergenic. So it means that it's suitable for all, for everybody. There might be one or two people for these plasters it doesn't work for, but pretty much if you see that word, so children, if mum brings a plaster home that doesn't have that word on it, you tell her, you need to go and get a hypoallergenic plaster for me. All right? It means it's suitable for all. Do you know what the Bible says about Jesus? Here's a verse for you. It says, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son. That's what we were talking about, Jesus dying on the cross and coming back to life again. He gave his one and only son that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life, should be able to go to be with him forever. There's no one that Jesus can't help and heal from their sin. No one's too bad. No one's done so many bad things. Nobody's so nasty that Jesus can't help them. Anybody can be helped by Jesus. And that is just the most wonderful news. And there's people in the Bible, there was one man who they had to tie up in chains. He was mad. They tied him up in chains because they couldn't control him anyway. When Jesus came, Jesus talked to him, and just by speaking, was able to make that man better and make him his friend. So he helped that man. There's a famous man in the Bible called Paul. Hands up if you've heard of a man called Paul in the Bible. Well done. Yeah. And Paul used to be called Saul. And when he was Saul, he was a really, really horrible person. You would not want to be around Saul because he used to go around and he'd kill people. If he heard that you liked Jesus, he would kill you. He was horrible. But do you know what? God loved Saul and changed his life around and made him better and a really nice person. And he became one of the best friends of Jesus. And he just loved to tell people about him. So nobody's too bad. Nobody's too old, because the Bible talks about old people as well coming to know Jesus, for Jesus to be their friend. So this morning, we've just been thinking about Jesus being a friend, the best friend of all, the best friend ever. And that's what this church is about. That's why we have Lighthouse. It's why we have Epic. It's why we have Friday Fun Time. It's why we do all the other things that we do. It's why we do Holiday Club, you know, and the Easter egg hunt, because we want people to know that Jesus is the best friend. I want to say thank you for coming along to Epic, Friday Fun Time, Lighthouse, and all of those things. Keep coming and we'll hopefully learn more and more about Jesus. I'm going to ask Graham to come and have a little prayer with us just now. Then we've got some special things to do before we've finished this morning. Thanks, Graham.
Kids, I've been listening to what Stuart said about friendship and stuff like that. So I'd like to pray a prayer on your behalf about what being a friend means. And I'm also going to pray for your mums and dads as well, okay? Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you for everything we've heard this morning. It's so good to hear these things. And Lord, as we think about friendships, Lord, those of us that have been around for a bit longer, we can think of some fantastic friendships that we have, and also some failed friendships as well. And Lord, my prayer, our prayer this morning, from I'm sure every adult in the building, is, Lord, that you will look after each and every child and young person here with us this morning. That you would bless, Lord, and protect them in their lives. That you would protect them from those that would do them harm. And that you would give them the strength to know the difference between what's good and what's wrong. Lord, we pray for friends, for people that will encourage us and help us. And we pray that you will make us smart enough to spot those people that would do us harm. But Lord, when we find those people, when we see those people, the backstabbers, the people that are dissing us, the people that try and make us unhappy, we pray, Lord, that rather than spite back, that we will pray for them and forgive. It's so, so difficult. It's so, so difficult. But we pray, Lord, that you would help us to do that. That each one of us would be a really good friend to somebody. That we would be strong enough to stand up for them. That when things go wrong in their lives, that we won't desert them. That we will stand by them in good and in bad. We also pray, Lord Jesus, that we will have friends that love us so much that they can tell us things sometimes that we don't want to hear. People that can put us straight when we go wrong. And people that are tough enough to say tough things, but always in love. Lord, I'm thinking of some tough things at the moment, and we pray especially for little Elisa. Think of the information that Peter gave us when he read out the notice at the start of the service. That tiny little life, Lord, is so much in your hands. We pray for the surgeons with that operation that's to come. We pray, Lord, that it will be really successful. And Lord, for any other and for the other work that it seems needs to be done, Lord, we pray for that too. And we lift that little life up to you, Lord. And we also lift Callum and Emma up to you. They are tough people, but I'm sure, Lord, that there will be times when they really, really need you. And we pray for them, and that you will lift them up, that they will feel strong, they will feel confident, and they will really feel on top of it. And Lord, we pray for Elisa's grandparents, and we thank you for them. And pray, Lord, that you will give them the energy and the wisdom and everything too that they will need, and I'm sure the wider family, for this little life. Lord, we pray for this whole family. And Lord, I'm sure there's not an adult in here this morning that certainly an adult that prays, that doesn't pray that every little life here this morning will come to know you. We do pray. Lord, we pray for the mums and the dads. It's so difficult being a parent at the moment. So many pressures, so many issues, so many aggravating tensions here, there, and everywhere. Lord, we pray for mums, and we pray for dads, and we pray for parents. Lord, bless them and strengthen them and give them the courage to do what they know is right. We do pray. And more than anything, Lord, we give you thanks for the friendship that you give us, which, unlike us, will never fade, never backs off, never walks away, is always there. We thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen.
Wonderful. Okay, what I'd like to do, the food will be ready in about 10 minutes. So just mix and mingle, have a chat, 10 minutes wait, just waiting for the last little bit on the sausages. Then they'll come in and they'll tell us. And then make your way through the doors here. And I'm told it's obvious what is going to happen. All right. You can eat in there, or if you want to sit outside. Actually, you can't sit in there because they've got the chairs from the coffee shop in there. You can come back in here. But I think most of us will be able to sit in there. And we're going to have a prayer just as we finish. Father God, we thank you for being the best friend. Thank you for Jesus. Thank you for all that happens with the children and the young people in the church here. Thank you for the food, for the barbecue that we're going to enjoy. Thank you for those who've got it ready, and help us to be grateful to you in everything. Amen. Amen. Thank you, folks. If you've got any questions about anything, about what happens at church, you're more than welcome. Speak to me, or somebody that you know comes along. If you just dropped in today and you think, could I do this every Sunday? You could, but you might want to have some information on that. Just speak to one of us.